Hi students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and this is the day 5th video, which was not in our schedule, but I wanted to do it because we were doing something very monotonous from these 4 days, and the videos, worksheets, everything got so boring, right? So I thought of doing something new, something fresh, and that really helps you to improve. Actually, the whole course is designed to improve your speaking skills and your writing skills and your English language basically. But when it comes to spoken English, we are very, I think we lack somewhere, and we hesitate while speaking English. We do not know how to pronounce few words, and sometimes we know what we want to speak, but we don't, we could not speak. We have a fear in our mind that the other person will laugh at me or will laugh at you, right? There in English language, there are some words, there are some things and some minor things that people actually use entirely in an incorrect manner. So I have 20 common errors in spoken English that I want you not to do in your daily life, and just try to improve your English using these rules, or some using these rules of not making mistakes. Second thing is that I have some members in our WhatsApp group, but some students are not there in the group. I want you to join the group because we are going to start the group discussion from today only. Anything else I wanted you to know? No, we will just learn by rules, right? So in this we have some rules that we have already done and something new also. First is that wedding and marriage. Whenever it comes to marriage, we always use that my sister, I went to my sister's marriage, I went to my brother's marriage, I have to attend a marriage. But you are incorrect, you are wrong here, because marriage is something that is a social institution or a bonding, a relationship between a man or and a woman, right? But the function that we go to attend for the marriage ceremony is called wedding. So whenever you say that you are going to someone's marriage, it means you are going to attend their wedding ceremony. So never say that I'm going to attend the marriage, always say that I am going to attend a wedding, okay? Because the ceremony that happens there is called marriage, but the function is called wedding or wedding ceremony, right? Then second comes the thing, ask for, ask to, and ask about. We are very used to saying that I asked to him, I asked to my boss, I asked to my parents. But whenever you use the word ask, it means you are going to ask someone. But if there is a person's name after ask, like your parents, your mother, your father, your boss, so never use to. I need to ask my boss is incorrect. I need to ask my boss, not to. I need to ask my boss, I need to ask my father, my mother. I need to ask my boss. It is not like I need to ask to my boss. No, never use to when you have a person after ask. Okay, when ask, what does the ask for mean? Ask for means you are sitting here and you want something that is lying in the other room, and you want someone else to bring that thing for you, right? Suppose I'm here, sitting here, and I want a glass of water, and I ask for a glass of water. I ask you to bring a glass of water for me. I asked for a salary hike. I asked him for a cup of coffee, right? It means you are eager to get something, you want to get something, and then you use ask for. Then comes ask about. Ask about means to inquire about something. You are at a window of railway office and you want to know about the train that is going to a particular destination. Then you use ask about. It means you are inquiring about something. You want some information that is required to you, and you are fetching that information from someone. Then you use ask about. I ask about your health. I ask about your job, your well-being, and then I asked about the train schedule. It means I'm inquiring about something that is related to you, that is related to something else. Then comes ask to. Ask to is something used when you want someone to do something. Suppose I am here and I want you to finish your assignments, right? So I asked you to finish your assignments and they asked me to help them. I asked my brother to turn off the light, right? Whenever you want someone else to do a thing for you, you ask to. I hope you get the difference between ask for, ask to, and ask about. Ask for is for you want something really bad. Ask to is something that you want someone to do a thing for you. And ask about is something that you want to inquire about something, right? Next, we have suggest and recommend. Both are used in the same manner. Suggest and recommend is that you are advising someone to do something. But when you use these two words in a sentence, never use to, never, right? I recommend you to get more exercise. No, I recommend you more exercise. I recommend you getting more exercise. Like things. I suggested that he sees a doctor. I suggested seeing a doctor. Never use the word to with suggest and recommend. He recommended me going for a walk. He suggested me waking up early. He suggested me some books. He recommended some books. He recommended some kind of medicine, shampoo, anything you want to write, but never use to in the sentence whenever you are using suggest and recommend, right? Then the fourth error that we make is that pass and spend time. There is a huge difference between these two words because passing your time and spending your time are two different things. For example, you go to a salon with your friend or your sister and you have nothing to do there, right? You have time, but you can't do the thing that you like. Then you pick up the thing that you least like doing. For example, I am sitting in a waiting room and I want to pass the time. What will I do? Either I will scroll down the newsfeed on my phone or I will pick up a newspaper and read it. So that is passing time. It means that you have a time, leisure time, that you just want to let go away. That is passing time. But spending time is something that you are adding value to your time. Like, I like spending time with my friends. That passing time is something different. Spending time is something different. I like reading books to spend my time. I spend my time reading books. I pass my time reading books. It means that you just don't read books to get knowledge. It means you are just going away, going through the pages of the books and going through the pictures in the book, but you are not reading it properly. But if you say that I spend my time reading book, it means that reading book is your hobby and you love doing that. Sometimes to pass time, you do things that you don't like. Suppose I have a game in my phone and sitting in a waiting room, I have nothing to do. What will I do? I'll pick up that game and start playing that. I know that I don't like that game, but I want to just pass my time. That is why I started playing that game. So there is a difference between passing and spending time. So whenever you are speaking something about something that you really like doing, then you spend time on that. But if you don't like doing something really well, then you pass time. So speak, but before thinking, what are you going to speak out of your mind or out of your mouth, right? Then there are irregular plurals. We in the school, when we were in the school, we were taught that if you are not getting the plural of a noun, then just do one thing, add s or es. We all get to know that some teachers that who used to teach like this, which is very harmful for us right now, right? So people these days, what they do actually is that they have no knowledge of English language, or just they want to boast about that they have a great knowledge, because speaking English has become a taboo in our society, that people these days don't think before speaking. They just want to speak English, right? Just to leave an impact on your life, that that person speaks fluent English, she speaks English like this. This has become our mindset, that a person who speaks English is very great. He has great lifestyle and something of great strata in the society. Nothing like this. If you speak your regional language well, it means you are language is just a thing to communicate. English is also a medium to communicate, but sometimes it does overpower us, our society, our mindsets. Okay, a person speaking Hindi is regarded as illiterate, uncivilized, and a person speaking English, even though he is not speaking correct English, but respect that person. That is the thing. So here comes the rule number 5, where there are some nouns whose plurals are not made using s or es, like child, children, leaf, leaves, life, lives. But people are unaware about the things and they say, I have 3 childrens. Really? You have 3 childrens? Children itself is a plural. You have 1 child and you have 2 children, right? Their lives are very good. Are you really serious? Lives? No. Their lives are very good. Okay? So there is a different, that whenever you are speaking, just never use incorrect plurals, right? Sometimes when you start speaking English, words do come out as an incorrect way, but you have to improve that, and for that you need mirror practice, right? For mirror practice, you can do like choose a topic, stand in front of the mirror and start speaking on that topic. Look at your face. How do you pronounce words? Where do you lack and where do you stop? You may have a phone. You can record your own voice. You can listen to that. Find your own errors and just keep reminding yourself that whenever you are going to speak this thing in front of anybody, you are not going to make that mistake, right? Okay, so here comes the rule number 6, that is in-laws. Many people say that there are so many people in my in-laws. That is incorrect. Like, I have 2 brother-in-laws, I have 3 sister-in-laws. That is incorrect. I have 2 sisters-in-law, I have 2 brothers-in-law, I have 1 mother-in-law. Okay, so never make that mistake. You do make these kind of mistakes when you start speaking English, but that is natural. But I want you to keep that in mind. Whenever you watch this video, you will get to know that yes, I made this mistake at this point of time and I'm not going to make that again. These rules were simple, quite simple. Moving to the next comes women, lady and madam. In our houses or yours or mine, my mother used to say, let's see a lady doctor. We went to a lady doctor, right? We all say that a lady doctor was there in the hospital. But what does that mean? It is actually incorrect. If I'm just breaking your heart, but it is incorrect. Okay? So women, what is a women? Women is a word, feminine word that refers to gender. It means if we are using the word women, that means the person we are talking about is a female, right? It specifies the gender. But if we are talking about lady, if you can recreate the scenes in your mind, what is a lady? Lady is regarded as, we refer to a lady who is a woman with high characteristics and moral values, a great social ranking, and whom we look upon as a perfect girl, a woman who has been raised well, who has been very polite to you, talks in a very sophisticated manner. That word is used for a lady, right? So whenever you say that a woman doctor has been sent for, it means that is not a lady doctor, it is a woman doctor, or it is a female doctor. That specifies the gender, not the character or the moral value a person possess. Okay, because if she is a doctor, it doesn't mean that she is a lady. She has high moral value, she has sophisticated manners and all. Okay, then whenever it comes to the word lady, you do not use a singular form to directly address a woman. Suppose you want to enter the class, you won't say that, may I come in lady? No, never use the word lady whenever you are directly approaching or directly addressing a woman. So always use madam, may I come in madam, right? But in general manner, you don't use the word madam. Like suppose you are going on the road and a thief just came and stole a lady's bag. So you will not say that he stole a madam's bag, he stole a lady's bag or a woman's bag, right? I hope that is clear to you. Lady, women and madam are three different things to be used at different times. So keep that in mind. It is a women doctor or female doctor, not a lady doctor, please. Then use of because. A very simple word. We all use this in our English language, day-to-day life. Maybe I use it 100 times a day. But what is the correct uses of this? Whenever in a sentence, you write the reason, then you don't use the word because is the reason. It means, suppose I write a sentence here, I left the job because whatever is the reason. But if I write that the reason I left the job, is here. Okay, so it is like because itself means reason. So in a sentence, we can't use two reasons two times or twice. So never use because after the reason. The reason I resigned is because I was not prepared for the job is incorrect. The reason I resigned is that I was not prepared for the job, or the reason I resigned because I was not prepared for the job. I resigned because I was not prepared for the job. Then rule number 9, it says that formal and letter. We have discussed this in the group, and it means formal means there are two people and two. If you want to point out the first person, you say former, and just to highlight the second person, you say second person or second thing, you say letter. It is used in the spoken as well as in written language. Ram and Shyam are intelligent students. The former is good at mathematics. Former means Ram, the first person. And while the latter is good at English, it means the second person, Shyam, is good at English. Then there is very common mistake that we all make is that to give and take exam. We all say that I have to take the, I gave the exam was very tough, but you are incorrect, you are wrong, because exam is the paper that is given to us and we take that. So basically we take the exam and the examiner give us the exam, right? So I took the exam, I am taking the exam, or I was taking the exam, not giving the exam, right? So keep that in your mind whenever next time you write an exam experience, write that I took that in the exam or I appeared in the exam. Then in English language, the word fastly, we all say that come fastly. No, that is incorrect. There is no such word in English language that says fastly. It is always fast. Fast, fast, and only fast. Run fast, come fast, eat fast, go fast, this thing. No fastly. Then rule number 12 say what says among and between. Among is used when there are two more than two people, and between is used when there are more than, there is less than two or two people. Like distribute the candies between Ram and Shyam, and distribute the candies among Ram, Shyam and Mohan. When there are two people, we use between, and when we have more than two people, we use among. Simple, clear? Then we have misplaced nouns, verbs and adverbs, modifiers. Modifiers, it means that they're a part of sentence that we just place to fulfill the information. Right, suppose I gave him the flowers. The flowers were in the refrigerator, right? I gave him the flowers in the refrigerator. Okay. So here, he threatened to divorce her often. Now the placement of often is incorrect. He often threatened to divorce her. Suppose in English language, in Hindi, if I give you the example in Hindi, वो उसे तलाक देने की धमकी देता है कभी कभी. Then think of this, where will you place this कभी कभी? वो कभी कभी उसे तलाक देने की धमकी देता है, ठीक है? So here often will be placed after he. We gave the cakes to the customers in the refrigerator. Now, just read the sentence again. We gave the cakes to the customers in the refrigerator. If I read it like this, it means that customers were in refrigerator. Were they? No. Cakes were in the refrigerator. We gave the cakes in the refrigerator to the customers. Okay, so the placing of the adverbs, nouns, modifiers is very important. He offered to paint the wall last night. So last night will come first. Last night, he offered to paint the wall. Clear? You will get to know these things when you write about them. And I am going to give you a topic to write. So just be prepared for it. Then rule number 14, parallel verbs and phrases. Suppose you are having two parallel verbs that just working together, and how will you use them? She was late for school and punished by her teacher. It means you have two parallel verbs. She was late and she was punished. So here we have a missing helping verb which was used here. The same helping verb will be used here. She was late for school and was punished by her teacher. So it will be correct. Never miss the parallel helping verb as well. He learned to play violin, to swim and sail. We have to play violin, to swim and to sale to make the sentence correct. Then comes the word beside and besides. Beside means next to me, and besides means something in addition. He came and sat beside me, right? It means the person came and sat next to me. Besides study, it means except studies, he is doing well in sports. It means in addition to his studies, he is doing well in sports. Great? Clear? Okay. Moving to rule number 16, we have done it already, the sequence of pronouns. Sequence of pronouns means that first person, second person and third person. First person is I, we, second person is you, and third person is he, she, it. Right? So, whenever you are using singular pronoun, then the order will be you, he and I. It means you will place the second person first, third person second and first person at the last. It is for the courtesy, for the manners you have, just you have to put the others first. But if the nouns are in plurals, okay, if the nouns are in plurals, then it will be 1, 2, 3, first person, second person and third person. We, you and they will visit the slum. Can you get the difference? If you have singular pronouns, then 2, 3, 1. If you have plural pronouns, then 1, 2, 3 for the positive sentences, not the negative ones. But if the sentence is negative, what are you going to do is that you will put yourself first. That you are going to be blamed first, then the other person. Then you will come first. Third person will come second, and the person standing in front of you, it means the second person will come at number 3, means at the last. I, Sunita and you are equally guilty. Get it? Whenever there is a bad thing that you are going to be punished for or you are going to be blamed for, then keep yourself first. Third person at number 2 and second person at number 3. Then the word news. We never use any a or an article before the word news. Only the can be used, and news has no plural. A news is fake, the news is fake. Get the difference? No a and an article with news, only the. Then rule number 18 says words ending with age, ary and ans. E-A-G-E-E-R-Y-A-N-C-E. We have already done it. Homage, baggage, luggage, hostage, patronage, heritage, jewelry, poetry, maintenance. These kind of words have no plurals, always used as singular. He broke my crockery is incorrect. He broke my crockery is correct. Okay. Then rule number 19, we have units, dozen, dozens, hundred, hundreds, pair and pairs. I bought 2 dozen bananas, this is incorrect. I bought 2 dozen bananas, it's correct. 500 rupees has been spent and 500 rupees have been spent, incorrect. Reason being that all the units as 100, 1000, million, billion are used for singular and plural both same. If you have singular, the units are going to be singular only. Clear? And the last is the use of the. Where do we need to use the and where do we not need to use the? When there comes the mountains, series of mountains, you use the, like the Himalayas. But if you are talking about a mountain peak, in that then you will not use the. You use the before the names of the oceans but not the rivers, right? Then before the names of a particular island, you don't use the. But if you're talking about seas, bays, gulfs and deserts, canals, then you use the. If you're using a language name like Hindi, English, Punjabi, don't use the. But if you're talking about aeroplane ships, trains, then you have to use the. And if you are using the name of a religious book, you have to use the Ramayana, the Hindu, even the newspaper. If you're using the name of a newspaper, you have to use the. But if you there is a name with the book like Tulsi's Ramayana, so you will not use the. And the is not used before the proper nouns like Delhi, Patna, Jaipur, but it is used before directions, government branches, historical places like the Taj, the Qutub Minar, the Golden Era, like this. And if you're talking about some subjects like physics, maths, then you don't use the, but means of transport, the bus, the train, anything, then you use the. Then comes the uncountable nouns like gold, silver, that you cannot count, you don't use the. But if you're using the numbers, the first, the second, the third, then you are using the. Before the meals, if you're having lunch, I am having the dinner, that is incorrect. Before meals, we don't use the. But if you're using referring to a political party, musical instrument, scientific tools, inventions, or part of your body, like he has cancer in the lungs, right? So you will use the. This is the last slide and last rule. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you would like this video. For any doubt, you can email me, and this is not the email ID I would refer to. The email ID is learner.bankexamstoday@gmail.com.